this season. In the previous nine, they are 0-9-0. Shitty game going on. Brazeau emerges, tosses Krug aside. Lauko goes to work against Matthew Kessel. Boquist to Brazeau, and he scores! Pure hustle and grit! And the Boquist line lifts the Bruins.
And you hope that's exactly what this goal does. Gives this Bruins team a little bit more engaged emotionally in this one. You know, this started out in the neutral zone when they won a puck just outside the offensive blue line, and they kept it going in the deeper part of the offensive zone, and it's a good bounce. But you get rewarded for good effort with good bounces. And again, Boquist with a beautiful read to seal off the near boards. A quick little nice feed on the back end down low to Brazeau, who attacks the net. Lauko's trying to get open in the slot. Just good decisions, good recognition. Off the goal stick, maybe Torrey Krug got his stick in there as well with that pump, that puck up in the air.
St. Louis is challenging for offside prior to the goal.
We said it started out in the neutral zone. And St. Louis is going to challenge. The Bruins came across that blue line after winning that puck just outside the offensive end. Wow, this is a huge call. Because you want that goal to be meaningful emotionally for Boston. And if this call goes Boston's way, they get the power play. I mean, St. Louis has got to feel pretty good about challenging this. You got to take it back again and see when this puck enters the zone and where Brazeau is. Get our best look at it as possible here. It all depends on where that right skate of Brazeau is when that puck crosses the blue line.
From the first glance, I think he's offside. The skate needn't be in contact with the ice.
The other question is, how does the puck enter the zone, Jack? You know, is that St. Louis bringing that puck back in their own zone?
Huh.
I mean, I don't think that's Brazeau pushing the puck across the blue line.
Right.
And I think Krug's trying to pull that puck away from Brazeau, and that's how it entered the offensive end. And I'll be curious to see if that's part of the judgment call.
All right, here it is again. And Krug touches the puck and brings it into his zone. So it can't be offside.
Well, you got the linesman looking at it down there.
If they had that angle and they have access to all angles, it's a goal.
Yeah, I just don't know if Krug is deemed in possession of that puck and brings it in his own zone.
Therefore, there's no goal on the play.
Oh.
Please reset the clock.
What?
9:06.
We missed the explanation. Clearly pulls the puck over the line.
Yeah, and it never comes back out.
Effort plays, but it gets overturned.
Yeah, so there's 5-6 bodies right outside the blue, and the puck is back into the zone. Brazeau fends off Krug, shows his strength, takes a hit to make the play. Watches, he's going to spin away, he's going to come back, and I love how demonstrative he is, eventually coming right towards the net raiser. This really isn't a shot, it's like a backhand, and it lofts off Hofer's stick into the net over him and in, but it was all about the strength of decisiveness until this happened.
Anytime you hear the challenging offside 30 seconds after the goal gets scored, you're curious. And
is it because he didn't have control of the puck? Is that it?
I'm not sure, but it aggravates me when we don't get the microphone to work from the NHL referees down here and get somewhat of explanation. I mean, it's the easiest thing in the world. You make sure everybody knows so we all know, and then we can discuss it. And because right now, I'm not sure. I don't know why or how. The Krug touched the puck last. It came into the zone off of his stick. Was it because he didn't have control? Was there something else that I'm missing in the fine print of the rules? Because it looked like it was Krug who touched it last.
We thought maybe Brazeau had touched it a little bit, and that would then create
an offside. Or did Brazeau touch his stick enough and knock it in? Does that, like...
I don't know. I'm not sure. No, I'm with you. It's a pet peeve.
It drives me nuts.
They were doing it for a while, and then they kind of got away from it, just saying good goal, no goal, or whatever. There's a few officials that really do it well.
Yeah.
And so, anyways, it's... You know, sometimes the, I don't know, maybe the electronics didn't work.
Yeah, we just have to, like the NFL, I just go, you watch NFL on Sundays, even if it's an explanation for 2 minutes, I'd rather a 2 minute explanation than just a no goal, wave it off and move on.
Yeah, I don't get it. I don't. I think it's a goal. I don't know how it, anyways, it isn't because
they called it
that right. Kind of night.